Welcome to Civil Services Achievers Point. We are discussing today the Assam Tribune of 23rd September 2020. At Civil Services Achievers Point, we have various courses. You can join the courses by calling at the number given below. You can also follow us on the social media platforms. This Assam Tribune analysis is based on the new pattern of APSC. It is also useful for UPSC and other state level government examinations. These are the answers to the MCQs of 22nd September 2020. These are the MCQs of 23rd September 2020. You can pause the video here and you can attempt the MCQs and you can mention the answers in the comment section. These are the important newspaper articles of today's Assam Tribune and the important editorials. So students, let us begin with the news articles first. So government is emphasizing on the infrastructure development in Northeast as per the statement of Prime Minister Narendra Modi. So whenever any such statements come from the Prime Minister or President, then such statements are very important from our civil services examination point of view. And he said this in the 22nd convocation of IIT Guwahati. And this topic we can study under the General Studies 3 paper, Economic Development. The Prime Minister Modi said, the Northeast is the center of India's Act East policy and new opportunities are being created here as the government is laying emphasis on development of infrastructure, including railways, highways, airways, and waterways. So the government is focused on the Northeast as the Northeast is the center for India's Act East policy and new opportunities are being created as the government is giving emphasis on development of infrastructure, including railways, highways, airways, and waterways. So the Prime Minister was addressing the 22nd convocation of the Indian Institute of Technology, IIT Guwahati, through video conferencing. He also said that now the education is going to be the another medium for our engagement and IIT Guwahati can become a major hub for this. It will also provide new opportunities to the Northeast. Major infrastructural development projects in railways, highways, airways and waterways are being taken up to give fillip to development of the Northeast. Also, Assam and the Northeast is full of possibilities, but we have certain challenges like the floods, earthquakes, landslides and industrial disasters affect the region. Energy and efforts of the state governments of the region get spent in tackling these issues. So the government's energy and attention is most of the time is given to the floods, earthquakes, landslides and industrial disasters. So the Prime Minister has also said that a high degree of technological support and intervention is needed to effectively deal with such problems. So he requested the IIT Guwahati to set up a center for disaster management and risk reduction. Such a center can provide expertise to handle disasters in the region and could also convert challenges into opportunities. So these statements are very important. You can use these statements in the mains answer writing. Further, the Prime Minister said that with the transformation in the economy and society, there is also a need to bring changes in the science and technology landscape of India. And he was very happy to make a note that IIT Guwahati has already started making efforts in the direction. Now coming to our next topic, World Rhino Day celebrated. Now this topic we can study under the General Studies 3 paper, Biodiversity and Environment. The World Rhino Day was celebrated on 22nd September. So this is a prelims based facts. Students, please make a note of it. A question on this may come in the upcoming prelims examination. The day was marked with official telecast of Save This Rhino India, a documentary in the National Geographic Channel, which was presented by the cricketer and conservationist Kevin Peterson. Coming to the next important newspaper article, Parliament passes bill to bring cooperative banks under RBI supervision. This we are studying under the General Studies 3 paper, Economic Development. So the Parliament has passed amendments to the Banking Regulation Act to bring cooperative banks under the supervision of RBI. It is done to protect the interest of depositors. The Banking Regulation Amendment Bill 2020, which replaces an ordinance that was promulgated on June 26, was passed by the voice vote in the Rajya Sabha. So why this bill does? The bill, which comes in the backdrop of the PMC bank scam, seeks to strengthen cooperative banks by increasing their professionalism, enabling access to capital, improving governance, and ensuring sound banking through Reserve Bank of India or RBI. So there will be certain changes in the governance, and it will ensure the sound banking through the RBI. The finance minister has said that in the last 1.5 years, we came to know of so many cooperative banks or cooperative societies functioning as banks and calling themselves as banks falling into difficulties. So the cooperative banks are falling into difficulties. The minister said that the amendments to the Banking Regulation Act have been brought to completely protect the interest of depositors. Now coming to the next important newspaper article, the Lok Sabha passes 3 labor codes. So this we are studying under the General Studies 3 paper, Economic Development. The Lok Sabha has passed 3 labor codes, and the labor minister has said that the house is witnessing a historic day, as these codes would provide salary security, social security, and proper environment at workplaces to the workers of the country. So this point is important. In the upcoming prelims exam, these points may be given as the options, and APSC may ask to choose the correct answer. The objective of these laws is to provide all kinds of facilities and healthy environment to workers, adding that in the last 6 years, the government has taken several steps for employees, such as increase in maternity leave period to 26 weeks, allowing women to work in mine sector, and pension scheme for small traders. So these are various social security measures which are taken. So this is the beginning of the labor reforms. Further, the minister said that 3/4 of the recommendations of the parliamentary standing committee, which scrutinized the codes, have been incorporated in the bills by the government. So the Occupational Safety, Health and Working Conditions Code 2020, the Industrial Relations Code 2020, and the Code on Social Security 2020 have been introduced. Now, some of the features of these codes are mentioned here. The Occupational Safety, Health and Working Conditions Code 2020 will consolidate and amend the laws regulating the occupational safety, health and working conditions of persons employed in establishment and related matters. The Industrial Relations Code 2020 seeks to consolidate and amend the laws with respect to the trade unions, conditions of employment in industrial establishments, or undertaking investigation and settlement of industrial disputes. So students, please make a note of these codes and try to remember its features, because APSC may ask them in the upcoming prelims exam and the mains also. Now coming to the next important news article, India successfully flight tests indigenous target drone. So this we are studying under the General Studies 3 paper, security topic. India successfully flight tested Abhyas, a high speed target drone for the practice of weapon systems with realistic threat scenarios. So Abhyas is a high speed drone that can be targeted by missiles, during weapons system practice. The Defense Research and Development Organization, DRDO, has achieved a milestone with the successful flight test of Abhyas high-speed expandable aerial target from integrated test range at Balasore in Odisha. Now coming to the next important article, India threatens military aggression against Pakistan. Qureshi tells the Islamic Organization of Islamic Coordination, OIC. So this we are studying under the General Studies 2 paper, International Relations. So students, you can mention in the comment section that the members of the OIC, if India is a member of OIC or not, you can mention in the comment section, because a prelim based question may be asked here regarding the members of OIC. So you can mention in the comment section that is India a member of OIC, and the headquarter of the OIC, you can mention in the comment section. Now coming to the important editorials, deadly defecation. So this is regarding the, there is a myth, mythology or myths about the our Indian rhino, one horn Indian rhino, or the rhinoceros as a whole. So this we are studying because of the context of the World Rhino Day, which was celebrated on 22nd September. So these dates are important from our prelims perspective also. So the World Rhino Day is annually celebrated on September 22nd to boost conservation efforts launched worldwide combating the challenges facing the five species of rhinoceros. Now, what are the five species of rhinoceros? The most endangered amongst the five, with barely 72 numbers left, is the in the Ujung Kulon National Park, Indonesia, are the one-horned Javan rhino. So this national park is very important. APSC may ask in the prelims exam. And the 80-strong two-horned Sumatran rhino. So one species is the Javan rhino, one is Sumatran rhino, and one is the great Indian one-horned rhino. And the others are the African two-horned rhino. And the others are the two-horned African species, the black rhino and the white rhino. So there is a myth that the rhino's horn can cure many diseases, can be used as a remedy for many diseases. So due to these myths prevailing in Europe, India, China and Southeast Asia, the rhinos have been hunted from many centuries, and as a result, once it was found in throughout most of the world and mostly in Asia, but now it is on the verge of extinction. So through scientific experiment, it is found that there is no medicinal property in the rhino horn. So through a gradual awareness and through the participation of famous celebrities like Kevin Peterson, this may be this awareness may be spread to the people, and the poaching of rhino can be reduced. So this is important point for our mains exam also, and also the points which are mentioned are important from prelims perspective. So with this, student, we come to an end to today's current affairs classes. I hope this class was very helpful. Thank you for watching the video. Thank you.